hard work always pays you back. You sweat, push, suffer. But if you're led by your passion, this is actually the real opportunity to see pleasure into a job well done.
On race day, there's a lot of excitement and tension. A very important rule is to put on your wetsuit at least 30 minutes before the start. This allows you to do it calmly and properly and to avoid tearing it or putting it on awkwardly. The best way to arrive at an Ironman race fresh and full of energy, apart from reducing the amount of exercise during the days or weeks before the race, is to pay great attention to your nutrition, balancing carbohydrates, proteins and fats, and avoiding what people used to do, overdoing the carbohydrates and arriving at the race a bit bloated. During the last 2 weeks, I also use Enervit Just Flow with cocoa polyphenols, which helps improve blood circulation. To avoid surprises, I try to go for a swim on the Friday or Saturday before the race to get a good idea of the seabed at the water entry and exit point. If the seabed is very shallow, you have to run a lot to reach the first buoy. But if the seabed descends immediately, as in the Pacific races, you have to dive in and start swimming. This is particularly important in multi-lap races where you exit and enter the water several times. Guys, one of the most common mistakes during triathlon races is to get carried away by the excitement on the day before the race and buy the latest model of super brand goggles used by champions and testimonials. I strongly discourage this. New goggles can mist up or let in water, and swimming 4 kilometers with misty goggles, unable to see the markers, can be a nightmare. Alessandro Degasperi, an old friend from many races and adventures together, fresh from your victory in the Lanzarote Ironman. Each race is different due to the climate and the routes. Last year we were in Edinburgh, starting at 6:30 a.m. with an air temperature of 6 degrees centigrade, a water temperature of 11 to 12 degrees centigrade, and rough seas. You did very well. How did you prepare for that race?
Under my bodysuit, I wore a fairly thick thermal underlayer and sleeves. I swam with it all under my wetsuit, even the sleeves.
The day of Ironman race is very long. It starts with the wake-up call before sunrise, almost always after a sleepless night due to nerves. I usually draw a timeline when I have a quiet moment on the day before the race, to set out clearly in writing all the times and procedures I have to follow before the start. from the wake-up to breakfast, going to the transition area, the time I have to spend checking the bike and the tires, putting the supplements in bottles, putting on the wetsuit, warming up and arriving at the start, raring to go. In this timeline, I carefully note each of the supplements I need to take at precise moments of the race, from the starting time at 6:30 a.m. until the end of the race. While competing in the bike race, I eat bars and gels, whereas while running, I only have gels. In order not to forget, I set my watch to remind me to drink every 20 minutes, so as not to neglect these important moments in the race. A precise and regular nutritional program is crucial to reach the end of the race with enough energy. Neglecting this will certainly compromise your final performance, and you'll have no energy to reach the finish line. Always have a good look at the first few meters at the exit from the cycling transition area in order to use the right ratio. If the first few meters are uphill, for example, I would use a 39 chainring with a 15, 16 or 17 cog. If, however, the exit from the transition area is flat and easy, I would leave a large chainring, a 53 or 54, with a low ratio, such as a 17 or 19. The great risk is not being able to cover the first few meters on the bike effectively and struggling to find your rhythm. On a challenging route, you can't arrive unprepared. You must study every detail, have your gears working well, and use the right ratios.
You need to inspect the route before the race, even in a car, because it's important to know where you'll be riding. This is quite a hard climb, and there's another 500 meter slope that's also very challenging. But I'll put a 28 on the back, which I'll probably only use on this slope. But it's important to use the right ratios so you don't end up having to get off the bike and push it for 500 meters.
Time trial bike or road bike?
Well, nowadays, we have to use time trial bikes because what you gain on the fast stretches is greater than the small amount you lose when climbing.
It's vitally important to know how to replenish your energy during an Ironman. Naturally, this varies for each athlete, depending on their weight, preferences and habits. But the equipe Enervit recommend taking 70 to 80 grams of carbohydrates per hour. A good option would be to alternate an Enervit Sport Gel with an Enervit Sport Competition Bar every 30 minutes. Never forgetting, of course, to drink Enervit Sport Isotonic Drink at regular intervals. In all Ironman races, you're allowed to place a special needs bag along the cycling route and the run route, and pick it up at the halfway stage. For safety, I'd recommend always adding an extra supplement and perhaps a sandwich. Or, like today, when the weather changes suddenly and the race becomes very long, including a vest and an extra pair of socks to wear. Most times you won't use them, but you never know. They could save you the race. A little trick I recommend, when you leave the bags in the transition area, take a picture. All the bags look the same and the racks are all identical. So, on the evening before the race, when I'm calm, I look at all the pictures to make sure that when I get out of the water, a bit disoriented after 4 kilometers of hard swimming, I can quickly find my bag. Thank you. The real Ironman begins when you put on your running shoes. The true challenge starts at the last 42 kilometers. You're a great runner, Ali. Give us some tips.
My advice would be not to set off too fast. Because after the cycling, when you start running and using different muscles, the mechanics change and you feel quite fresh in the initial phase. You can be tempted to set a pace that is too fast, and you'll inevitably pay for it after 10 or 15 kilometers. If you start paying for it after 15 kilometers, then reaching the finish will be very hard.
The final 32 kilometers are the most demanding and pose a greater challenge. You're plagued by several doubts, so your self-motivation needs to be at its highest. My advice is to take the time you need, particularly in warmer races, to get some refreshment at the aid stations. Perhaps someone might not stop out of fear of losing time, but this can jeopardize the race. So stop, have some refreshments, and take the necessary supplements, knowing that this will ensure that you finish the race at a good pace. After any significant exertion, whether in training or racing, I strongly recommend drinking Enervit Sport Recovery Drink within 30 minutes after finishing. It's the first step towards your next challenge.